I'll talk to Doc or ask Doc where he wants me to direct, where he wants me to go with this session. But I'll open the floor if anybody wants me to show anything special or any questions. I'm sure I can roll into a lot of stuff from any situation, from any question, whether it's folk style or freestyle. So anything, anybody? Drags and Ducks. All right, I'll cover both those. I think drags and ducks are really, really effective techniques. You don't see as many ducks as you have in the past, where Melvin Douglas and John Smith, quite a few other guys, used to attack those positions. I think drags are underutilized in this country. I think it's an effective technique. I think it's a technique that that needs to be used more, because it's not only an effective scoring technique, it's a strong setup to anything you want to do. So I'm going to show you a couple things from a drag situation. I'm sure you guys have all seen basic drag situations. Let me use you. Basic drag situations, but I'm just going to work on a couple, talk about a couple situations. And this is a deal. I mean, we all know this kind of stuff. Grab his wrist. Here's our drag. He grabs my wrist. Here's a drag. I mean, we've all seen that stuff. But I'm going to show you a couple different attacks and different techniques from here that's going to allow you to get in the position to score. Here's the deal. Most of the time, he'll grab my wrist. Most of the time, when I can attack this guy and drag a position, it's going to be when he's not expecting it, not when I have him. When I have him, he's going to be a little bit more defensive, bringing his elbow back. It's going to be very hard to get to him. But when he grabs my wrist, it's going to make my technique a lot more effective. And what I like to do here is I might be wrestling him in here too, controlling tie-ups, but I'm allowing him to hold my wrist. Most of the time when the guy grabs my wrist or any tie-up that's not mine, I'm clearing it right now. Very seldom do I hang in this position. Very seldom do I hang in this position. Very seldom do I hang in any tie-up that's not mine. I never hang in. You can't afford to hang in. He'll dictate the match. So I'll give wrist. I'll also make sure I'm not giving up tie-up control on the other side, because I can't give up both side controls. So I'll give wrist. Really simple, very effective technique is I'm going to roll shoulder, drop hand. Roll shoulder, drop hand. Big step, high. High in his armpit. And this is the whole key. If I drag hard enough where he falls, I run to his back. I can't get away with running to his back. I don't like that necessarily. This guy pops up, he wrestles, he rolls, what have you. Most of the time on a better guy, when I hit big step, I'll run to his leg. If he falls, pretty simple, pretty easy attack, pretty easy, pretty effective attack. Big key, throwing here. Pull hard. Also, when I pull him and he feels himself going and I'm here, he'll wrestle. Straight up. He'll wrestle here. So a lot of times I'm here and I'll try to win this position. Wrestle. And I'll lose him. Can't afford to lose him. I beat him bad. Freestyle, if I hit him and I come here and he starts wrestling out of position, I still run. Goes out of bounds. Here's my point. Here's my score. But realize, leg is always in my face. So if I drag here, look at my head position. Look where I'm at, shoulder in his armpit. Higher on the armpit, the better, the more control. I can go here first if I want to. Big time pull. Come on. More than likely, I'll go here, he reacts. I run through the position to my score, all right? Same thing here. Go down on your knees. Say I'm here, and I run. Stand up. See how leg comes to me? I'll lose a guy. I'll lose a good guy if this is my action. I gotta realize, legs coming in my face. Here, I go to run that. Run down. Run that side down. So I'll let you work on this. Big step. Big step. You can pull. You can pull. You can. But here. All right. Go ahead and try it.
You don't want to. I don't want to do this. I don't want to circle so much because he'll just pull away from me. I want to step and really hit. And also, once I hit, this isn't my action.
Pull him, yeah. You're gonna pull him to the ground when he drag that thing. Good. That brother's gonna finish that technique. Great! Let's look here. One thing I point out to everyone basically is mostly age group. But this is really important. And I see us doing it as coaches, so I know our athletes feel the way to this. You cannot allow your guys to do this. Relax. Get the leg. Release it. I mean, from any attack, you cannot allow this. Get the leg. Release it. Understand? At the age group level, even at the senior level, these guys got a lot of energy. Don't let them get away with this, because we know this is where the fight just starts. Right? This is where the fight's just now starting. So if our athletes are trained, if our athletes train every day attacking that leg and releasing it 10 times a day, 20, 30, 100 times a week, 1,000 times a month, what's going to happen when they're wrestling a guy that's going to really defend that position? How many times do we see our athletes? This is as a country. Get here and not finish a single. It's got to be 100%. Your guy has to be 100% from this position. Especially if it's freestyle, it's a 2-minute period. You might only get one opportunity to score a takedown in a 2-minute period. That has to be 100% as a country. We got to get better. Don't let them get away with it. They can get away with this. From here, don't stop. Block leg. Stay with me. Okay. Block leg. A lot of times when I block leg, he might fall down, but he catches balance. Here I am. Block leg. See how it comes to me? Ankle, secure the position. Stay up. Locking him in. From here, 100% finish. Now, if you want them to stop here, they can stop here. But no, they're. The more times a guy does something, the more habits, the more repetition, he's just gonna be in a match. Or here, step on his foot. Step on his foot as I get through the position. Either he'll jump over it or ankle's gonna come to me. From here, scissor step. Ankle. You can do this too. Don't do that for yourself. Don't allow your athletes to do that. All right, a couple more times on that drag. I'll come right from here. See this? I mean, you guys all know this. Banging. He's tying up outside. Banging. There's my step. Here's my finish. I can trip that thing or run him down. Here. Rolling it. Stretching my arm out. Rolling my hand over his elbow. Here comes drag, here comes step. I gotta step to his crotch here, unless he falls. If he falls, I run waist. Here it is. Get through the position. Right here. You guys seen this? That wax on, wax off. We, back in the day when we were teaching kids during that Karate Kid movie, it used to be wax on, wax off, you know? But here it is, rolling, pulling, just like a pass by. Here I am. Can roll right into a turk from there. All right, go ahead and try that one.
I did. I somehow did this.
when your kid's down points, it's hard to take a guy down when you're pushing him away. You ever seen your kid like this trying to win a match? He pushes, here comes a shot, here comes a shot, here comes a shot. Well, it's not effective because his baseline defense when he defends is to go away. So you can't have this guy, you can't be pushing the guy and attack him. So drags won't work. Very few attacks will work with me pushing this guy away, okay? So if I'm pushing him away, I gotta let him relax for a second. He falls back in, I can attack him. And that goes for all of your setups, all your attacks. He either has to be stationary or coming to you. He can't be, you can't be pushing. And this right here, that's not a legitimate attack. You guys see your kids do that? Anytime you leave a hand up on the guy, half shots are fine, but it's really not a legitimate threat of an attack. So when you have a kid and you want to get a guy caught for stalling, he's really not taking the risk to score. Anytime a kid wants to score, both hands have to go to a leg or legs. So we can't leave his hand up. Plus, anytime I leave a hand up, I'm pushing the guy away from my score, from my attack. Coach, good question. So, one other thing I'm going to show you from this drag situation is the reason the drag's effective, and I stepped inside one time because I went for a trip because it was a hard right leg lead. I also can step outside. So it's up to you what you want to attack. If it's a hard right leg lead, and tie me up, and I go to drag and hook, that's fine. So realize, I know I stepped one time inside, one time outside. It's whatever you're, whichever you like. One thing that's effective too is this, square stance or left leg lead, is this, tie me up. If I do this, he brings that back leg back. So I'll do this, do me,
what's that?
Drag me. I can't, see that? Anytime a guy drags, I gotta defend that drag, right? So with the setup, it happens like this. See it? Because he's gonna react, especially if you've dragged him once already. So it's a set. See it? It just fools him because he thinks you're gonna drag him. Especially if you've dragged a couple guys during the year or you've got a good drag. Again, and I don't have to move my feet like I'm really dragging him. I'm not going, coming back. I'm just gonna, it's a set. See it? And it can either be a swing or a straight shot. I prefer a straight shot, unless I get him to step. All right, go ahead and try it. Going to get him, I'm just showing it. All right, let's try it. From the feet as well, I don't have to hit knee. See, he defended. See there, you know what he was doing, so defend a little bit. Good. That's effective too. If I can get away with tacking legs from my feet, not having to hit a knee, I'll do that. That's why snatches are good. Slapping and doing what he just did are fine. One other position I'll show you, which is, I think the coaches might have seen this yesterday from an athlete in practice. But I can do this too. If you're running backside, you're dragging this thing, I can go off this wrist too. I mean, you can drag from any wrist, on me having his wrist, him having my wrist. Me being inside, it's hard for me to drag an arm that's inside me though. All right, so I gotta be inside, wrist control, or half his wrist. You can do this too. if I'm dragging here, you can do, if you like to do this and run with your head inside here, this is fine too. This kind of stuff. I'm not that high risk type wrestler. That's not, unless I have to. But I know a couple coaches asked about that. The key is I gotta have this arm. When I hear, this is the key. This, having control of that arm is the key. Because realistically, if I drag him, see, I'm here. See, the only difference is I keep head up sometimes. I can put head here. Single leg, double or high crotch. It's the same thing here from my position, front headlock. I think I've showed jab step enough times, but sometimes I'm here. I'll come here, double, or I'll come here and bulldog the position, getting through my angle. Or I'm here. Instead of head up, head tucks. Release. Here's my position. Same thing if I'm here. Head here. Whoa. Keep the chin. 3-point move. So you can go either one. You can go either way on that deal. You can play around with those if you like. Go ahead, guys. Good. Explosive action and he defends, you might get caught. So if you're going to hit any high risk or any maneuver really, and you're going to explode through it, you'll come out clean or you'll get points. All right, go ahead. Just a setup for whatever you want to do. So if you get that, if you get a drag and you're effective with the drag, everything else can spring from there. You can drag him, you can if he reacts, you got single, if he reacts hard, you got double. So there's a lot of combinations that can come off that drag. Go ahead. Drop straight down underneath him. Nah, you can, but I'd rather see me pushing by for that attack. That's good. Excellent. That's good. And the deal is, he won't fall sometimes, so your back leg has to fly. Okay? Yeah. You guys gone on front headlocks, right, already? You guys have? Front headlocks already? Doc? Right? A little bit from this position? All right, grab my elbow. Here. This one too. Okay. She's got my elbow. See, this is a hard position to defend, especially when he grabs both of them. This action, anytime I snap him, it'll force him to let go of my position. If anytime I snap him, he's not gonna go on his face. he's going to post hand or he's going to release so he can catch his balance. So most of the time, I can get him off this, let go of this one. Okay. I can get him off this one, and he's holding under this one. Or even if he's holding under this one, this is fine. All right. A couple things I do here. I can snap it. I can jab step him. See the position? I jab step him to keep him. I'm trying to keep his chin because I just want to bulldog the position and get through the angle. Easiest position to finish. If I go to bulldog him and he reacts, I come off his head and attack the position. One of the keys to this, I see a lot of guys right here, Grandma Abel. I see a lot of guys right here. And they do pull. I can't attack. See that? He'll react to that. I can never attack this guy from head out, releasing and going straight through him. He just down blocks with his arm and his head. I lose him. So I got to get rid of this arm. So I'm here. So what I'll do is I'll pass it. See me pass it? And I don't grab him like this per se. I grab him like this. You can get away with this. Especially when you're just passing him. Especially when you're just passing him. But I get a better feel when my thumb's inside. So here, pull, pass it. See how there's no reaction here? Then I can attack. Pull, pass. See it? See the pass? High crotch, I'd rather go double, but you can go high crotch. Think about all your attacks too, come up. Anytime you attack a position, whether it's high crotch, double, single, your back leg has to fly to a finishing position. If my back leg doesn't fly, he reacts. I'm in a defensive position. He's in a counter offense position. So anytime I attack, no matter what it is, that's the key. No matter what it is, that's the key. To get to my feet, to turn the corner. If I shoot single, that's the key. That's the key. Back leg flies, allows me to get to my feet to finish my attack. If back leg doesn't fly, your guy will fall over and be vulnerable to being countered. So let's work this time because this is a position we're all in. Elbow can't stay up, elbow down. Pass it. Allow yourself to extend. And I know you can't get away with this, like I'm bending this chin folk style or age group, high school, junior high. But you can pull it down in the way. You ready to release? Who knows what you're able to get away with? So here, rolling.
Roll it with that off. Principles are saying here. Sometimes we're here. I'm here. And we go to spin around. We go down. Your kid going back and front, right? Yeah. Anytime I'm here and I go to spin around, arm comes up, I won't release this position. Ankle or butt, drag. Pull to my score. Don't release it. But to stop all of that, I'm going to change my position. And it just kind of carries over from my feet to the mat. This explains the same philosophy that I'll use. From the feet to score, mess. It's the same. Get rid of this arm. So allow this arm to defend you. So here I'm at here. So instead of being here, see me changing from thumb outside, the thumb inside. Now his hand close. Again. Go get it. Okay. All I'm trying to do is beat his arm. Only thing beating your kid is this. So I'm gonna get rid of it. He didn't even have an elbow, which scares a lot of our kids. See this? From this post, single. It's up to you. All right, let's try. So, don't worry about this elbow. Realistically, see if he's up on his knee. Look at this. Look at this axe. See this? Come on. See that? He won't stay here. See it? Really, my philosophy, what I try to teach is from a position of counter offense, when you got this guy stopped on the shot, there should be things that you can do that are inevitably going to get you a score. He can't avoid the score, okay? So if I'm here, he's going to grab, see how he brings his knee up, and what he's trying to do is pass his elbow up, either drag it or stand up and pass me off, same thing, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But, see how he's up? I can't allow this really, unless he's really, I'm here. See it? This is a reaction. I'm waiting. If he stays here, I'll pull him up. He won't stay there. He doesn't want to get run around. So when I pop his head, be ready to adjust. Do that leg attack. All right, I know it's a few things, but you can play around those positions. Got any questions to ask? Go ahead. Pardon me? If I get a guy moving, or he goes to his elbows, I don't teach this, because I've seen more of my guys doing it. I see more of my guys lose this and not. If I snap him and get him coming forward, yeah, it's fine. If his elbows hit, that's fine. But what I see us, a lot of guys do this. You ever see this?
Yeah.
You ever see that? Real slick, real smooth, looks good. But the deal is, against a better guy, he will wrestle when there's no pressure keeping him in position. When I can't, when I'm not holding him in position, he will wrestle. So if I do this, I'll lose him. Unless I get him in the knees. Now if I pull him on his elbows, you can get away with anything you want to get away with. So if your kid misses a guy one time doing that, don't let him do it again. He's got to control either chin or he's got to drag down. One thing you can do too from the same position, say you're on, I get caught, I don't do the same thing to both sides. What's that called, ambidextrous?
Yeah.
I'm not that. So if I get caught down blocking on this side, instead of running here, or jab step running here, I'll roll ahead. The leg, to my single leg finish. I seen one of our athletes one time do the same thing. He got a guy here, come up. Pick him up from there. I'm getting a little old. I'm not going to keep doing that. But you can do the same thing. Instead of jabbing, coming this way, you can roll ahead. Take him, release, strong finish. And kind of along the positions, you're beating them so bad to a position, your finish has to be strong. If it's not strong, he'll catch back up to me in the thing. All right, let's try it. So, if this guy reacts, you got a leg attack coming. If I do this, and I run waist down, he might wrestle. But if you run knee down, ankle, or butt, when you go to run it and he goes to run out, you got a leg attack coming. You don't have the same thing when you run waist down. Okay? That's one of the key components of this being successful is, if I'm here, and I pull it, and I wrestle, I'll lose that guy. If I'm here, and I pull it out, to the position, he can't avoid that. He can't avoid that score. He can't avoid it if I run waist. All right? Coach asked about a kid, when my kids shoot. I don't know if we need to work with this or not, but it's a mentality thing. Who asked? Coach. It's a mentality thing. Guys don't recover from attacks. Our kids don't recover from attacks when those attacks are soft attacks or attacks that aren't set up. Attacks that are set up and exploded to can only be defended, not countered. Okay? So, what happened to us? We're here wrestling. Here I come. Hard to recover from that. It's true hard to recover from that. Now, you can recover from that if your back leg flops. You know what I'm saying? So if I'm like this, and we're out here wrestling, and I take this shot, see my back leg fly? Even though he defended, I can recover. Now, he would have flew off me a little more. You know what I mean? So, if you're going to shoot, if your kid's going to shoot a shot without a setup, if you're wrestling a kid, you see a team, and you fake on that, and your kid does this, or he smacks the kid, or he flashes on him, or bangs him, or whatever, and that kid reacts to this, that kid has to be set up. If you splash on a guy, if you smack him, or you fake and he reacts like this, he can be shot from an open shot, open stance. So I get away with this. I'm gonna flash you, come away. Yeah. I get away with that, okay? So, concept is, kids that can wrestle can downlock and crossbow. So that kid has to be set up. But the key to me not being counted on my attack is a strong set to a hard attack to my back leg line. Understand? So, what's a set? Bend at the waist, an angle, or a step. Or if I do this, and he reacts to it. Or if I'm like John Smith and I'm faking so much he never knows when I'm coming. Okay? Very few of those guys. Now if I got an explosive guy, I'll have to explode on the guy. Even the guy that can down block well. If he can explode through him, let him explode through him. Even the guy down block. Some guys are quicker, more powerful, more explosive than other wrestlers. Bunch, Muhammad Wall, a couple guys like that, Randy Slay, can blow through a down block. Sometimes. The guy's ready though, and he's well schooled, he'll take his legs away as he down blocks too. So, the mentality is setups before any attacks. Hard attack, back leg flies. Always trying to create angle. I mean, I can show you a couple things. I mean, if I'm here and I take a shot, and if I'm running on my knees to get to my feet, if my back leg flies, it brings me to my feet anyway. Where we can counter that is this. See, stop. Can't stop. So if I take a shot, even if he's a 10, I gotta wrestle. Okay? So I run on my knees, back leg flies, wrestle position. Okay?
Would you, high school situation, would you start kids in position and have them drill from that position? From neutral?
I started here sometimes. You know, like, see, this is the ball pass. Okay? This is the ball pass. Alright, yeah. If I'm like this, I'm a guy doing the technique. What's that mean?
Square tips.
Cover his head, right? Everybody agrees. Cover his head, right? How about here? Anybody say crossface, so that's what we're trying to get away from. I crossface a couple times. If I'm here trying to jam him, and he gets strong. Then we'll take it inside. Alright? Right? Okay. Anything else, especially at the age group level, I'm jamming, I'm pushing off, trying to, anytime he has leg, grab leg. Whichever leg he has, whether single or high cross, I'm always trying to get that leg as far away from his attack as possible. Only way I can do that is transfer hips. Now this leg's closer than the other leg. Single leg, same thing. Here, jam. Only way I'm in this position, place his hand with hip, and I pop him so his hand comes off. Now from here, slide my chest down his back, allow me to get overrun. For this kid, this is the problem. Once a kid is stopped, a lot of our kids are stopped. But what's he need to do? What's his situation? What should he do? That's fine. I'll defend that. That's good if he can get away with it, but do it again. Real hard to do that when I'm on his head. Okay? Right. Real hard to do that when I'm on his head. That's good stuff, though. Especially on a weaker guy. Because what happens with us, whether it's single or high crotch, we're not patient enough to stay on his head. So when I'm like this, look at this. I grab weights, so my body, so he's carrying all my weight. So see where I'm at? Russell. See here?
Sorry.
I can defend that.
Yeah.
So I'm like this, no, but sometimes it happens like that. pop it. If I don't pop it, I block hip or knee. You can't finish this, grab a leg. As long as I'm blocking hip or knees, you can't run through this. What happens with us, if it was high proctor single, we're here. As soon as this guy starts build up, we release his hand and we go to those wrists. Same thing high crotch. We're here. Stay on his head. Be patient enough. Be sound enough. This is baseline defense. Be sound enough that when he starts, say, when he starts building up, that you quit. What's he going to do with that? You know what I mean? Stay on his head. Force your kid to stay on his head. If he stays on his head, he'll win the position. Unless his kid's really good. Now, he can start, yeah, exactly. I'm right here. If I'm like, I start bringing him back, he should close that. I close hand. Everyone in the corner. I close hand around the corner like he did. He likes to grab me. And I'm under the impression, I don't care what you do. If it works for you, I don't care. So, I mean, whatever works for you, works for you. My philosophy and my techniques might be different. And that's why I tell a kid, if something works for you, don't let me change it. But this is the key. Staying patient on this hand, even when he starts coming up. Come on. Staying patient. See what I mean? Staying patient on this head. His head starts coming up. Staying patient on this head. You feel like they're moving? Sell the technique out. Understand? I brought the same thing. Patient on his head. Patient. And that's what I'm doing. He'll only go double. And now his hands are released, and you can defend the hole. Okay? One other thing I'll show you with the same block where I get to this dog action is this. From my feet, see this? Bend that knee. Look at this. Wrap. See what I'm at here? Now, well, how he wins this position, he can go ahead. Do it, go ahead. See? Philosophy is the same. Get through the position. Now, he got through me. I lost my balance, he took me down. If I catch my balance, he's in trouble. You see it? Because he's on the mat. I don't want to go down to the mat when I'm on my feet with a strong attack, unless he's going down. So if you're on your feet, stay on your feet. Because as soon as you go to the mat, I'm back in position to wrestle. Stay on your feet as long as you can. One other thing is here. Wrap it around here. This is the key. We can do this. Take our leg away. See that? He's beat. Went down to the mat. Here's the key. Head down. See me? This is the leg that's beating me. This is the leg that's beating me. But then we can have a jam all we want. But until you get off this foot, especially freestyle, runs me out of bounds on one foot. Until I get off this foot, I can't win. So, we call it settle the position out. So here, get off your foot. Say you went up like this. Hand's still locked. He still has hand. You're still locked in a better position than you were in your feet. But you need to just go into your baseline, leg back, square your hips. So the key is, to win this position, jam his head, sell it out, put off both toes. We say bend at the knees, then sprawl. All right? Now let's try that a couple times. From the feet, let's go. Or turn done. So even when I'm here, you gotta release. You gotta sell the position out. All right? Don't stand your toes. Knees, toes. All right, let's go. He fires a straight single. I should do this. Right? He fires a straight single. My reaction is here. See it? I dropped my weight up. Now I didn't even catch it with my hands. I just dropped weight up. When I drop weight, it stops. There's no weight on it. There's no weight on it. Back up. There's no weight on it. See what I'm at here? This stops it. This stops it and puts him in position. This does not. This does not. This. And then wrestle. Bend at the knees. baseline skill that as a country we have to get better in. Deep penetration leg defense, that's what we just did. Deep penetration leg defense, all right? And the problem is, we're vulnerable once we get here, because when you watch your collegiate rosters, they might get penetrated, but what happens? Here comes a roll, here comes the dive, here comes everything else. So when they hit a higher level, like the senior circuit, their baseline skills aren't intact, so it's easier to finish once a guy gets a leg. How many times do you watch like Mike Zadick or Hanson or some other guys get a leg up and they gotta give it up? Because they haven't been trained enough time. Because of the style of wrestling that they do, they're more used to this, turning, kicking, flipping, being their first line. But with this situation here, if this is your first line, well, not my first line, hand is my first line, but if this position, baseline defense, deep penetration, is effective, it automatically puts me in a counter offense position. The front headlock, whatever. It puts me in a position where I can counter. Now, if your athletes or our country gets better in this position, everything has to improve, right? My setups, my attacks, my finish, everything has to improve, so it starts from here. Now, I'm under the impression, like you guys, I'm American, that we want to be offensive, offensive, offensive. The problem is, I believe a great defense is a great offense. The problem is, very few of us have great offense. So it's very difficult to stay on your offense and be great, because very few of us. I mean, when I look at the last 10 years, I look at the Kale Sanderson, Steven Adams, you know. So who do I have a great offense at the Olympic Games? They can afford to do that, but majority of us, you know, I'm not there. So, these are baseline skills our kids have to have. So I have my kids doing that all the time. Deep penetration defense, and also this kind of stuff. Since kids dive so much, don't catch. Don't catch, don't catch. A lot of times I take a shot, He shoots, and I catch him. Right. I catch him. Okay? Especially when you're up by a point for 30 seconds, 20 seconds, whatever. Early in the match, our kids wrestling guys. You know the kids are shooting in the first 20 seconds. You know what I mean? The deal is, if I had a kid, and all I trained him to do is down block, sprawl and spin, kind of walk and stuff, he can wrestle with any of your kids. Now, if he got down by a point or two, he'd have a difficult time beating him, because you got to be able to hit the guy down when you want to. But just for him to do that, he can wrestle with anyone. Now, we want to be complete wrestlers, so it has to go hand in hand. Offense has to be good by defense and vice versa. So I also like just doing this. As soon as he shot, head in hand, boom, I'm running quick. I'm scoring now. Never catch. Never catch. Same thing here. He shoots, boom. Score now. Don't. And I see this more than I'd like to see it. Right. This is a bad action. But it can be rectified. But our kids feel this action is a pacifier. They feel safe. They're not safe. They're stopping themselves from scoring. And actually, if this guy's got a near far leg or fireman's carry, they're vulnerable. Okay? So, I don't want to have underhooks. I want to have catch hands. So when I get like this, whether it's one or it's two bare elbows, my first action is this. See how I posted on his triceps to keep him so he can't do this? So I'm here, and it's very violent action. To my knees, hit the mat. See it? Same thing in one. Here. Pressure allows me to get my arm out. Catch and run. Pretty simple. But the deal is this position is inevitable. It's going to happen every match, 2, 3 times, 4, 5, 6, 8 times a match. It's going to happen. Your kid's going to be here. So, if I'm going to be here, and I know it, we all know it, you have to be locked in on how to score
in this position. You have to be. It's going to happen. You guys, kids going to be there. So we got to be able to score from there. We're working on a few things already, and I'm sure you guys over here have your own philosophy of how you're going to score there. But as a coach of a team, you need to have your whole team locked in on it's going to happen. You're going to be there. How are we going to take advantage of it? And against better guys, you better be ready to run that leg attacks. Okay? I'll go over to Doc real quick. I know we want to go over some, Doc wanted to show some baseline positioning. But Doc, I mean, this is a very effective Doc. Outside, anytime I duck a position for the most part, I'm going to be same side, same leg. Same side, same leg. So I'm going to be as close to the attack as I can. I'm going to do this. See this? See this? But I bang like this. I mean, a lot of times you can't get away with that. High school, junior high, book style. But senior level, you can bang them hard. But you can get away with anything you want. I mean, if I pop a guy, bang the guy, and threaten that attack, you can get away with a lot of stuff. But if I just bang and smack the referee, he's going to stop me. Whatever. But at the senior level, you can, it's so hard to open a guy up in a good stance that they let you get away with more bang, more pop. And this is the deal. In wrestling, there's only so many weapons. So many. These are huge. These are huge. So, if your hands aren't working, not working in your behind the game. They need to be working. This is error. This is absolute error. Can't do it. Can't happen. I like to collar tie as much as another guy, but I can't give a collar. So, guys collaring me inside, getting off my collar. Now I can control it. Okay. So you're looking for this position. Never let a guy hang collar. So, I'm looking for collar, inside control. From here, I'm going to snap, lift, position down. Really, I'm just looking for that arm to come out. I'm just looking to beat his arm. See it? Look at my head. And this is the key, too. Any setup, especially hard sets, any set, my head has to beat his chin, or beat his forehead at least. I see guys do this. See that? You guys see that? See how his head, I never beat his head. Really, he could have probably shot me. See it? Also, when my head beats his head, I supply my own defense position. So I'm like this, and I said, see my head? Look at my head. If he shoots, he can't beat my head. Also, if I'm looking for my offense, see my head? Puts me in position to attack, because my head's beating his chin. If your head stays higher than his chin, or his forehead, you can't get under it. Also, when my head beats his head off heavy pulls, he's going to pop up. Allow me to attack. Because if it doesn't, if I have him set and he drops his head, boom, counter offense comes. See how it works together. So either my heavy set, he comes in, or heavy set, he doesn't pop up. Okay? It's a combination. He's either one. But here, duck it here. That's just simple. All I'm doing is lifting, pulling, guys start getting used to that one, we'll start stepping out. See it? See it? It's just a set, it's a combination. But that's a simple duck out there. I'll show one more. But let's just play around with this since your kids are here. Here. Set. Set. Remember, it's not a lift, it's a step. Oh my God. And if you're real slick, you can do it. You can do that too. All right, let's try it. Let's go. Now, from him with his head. Same side you're attacking has to be your lead leg. I can't go from here, too far to go. It's hard enough for me to go from a squared stance. Get that leg close. Close to your cap, close to your position. Go. They can't be left noodles. They gotta give reaction. They gotta give feel. What happens a lot of times when you watch our kids drill and you say drill, I see our kids drilling. You guys see a lot, you know? I see some guys drill and they'll take a shot shoot. And they just give it up. I mean, they just fall over. The deal about that is it gives them a false sense of really what works and it creates bad habit for me. If I give him a little bit of a feel, I'm not saying straight defense, although sparring is something that you need to incorporate in your training, but if I give him a little bit of a feel, shoot. Same thing. But you see what I mean? That's a mentality. That's a. So if he's a kid and he does that 10 times, 50 times, 100 times, 1,000 times a month, what's going to happen when he gets a state champion? That state champion's not crossing. He's going to release. He won't score. We got to win. So he does it again. See, yeah. You know what I mean? But nothing special, nothing hard, nothing crazy, but I'm not just falling over. Plus, it gives me more repetition doing the correct thing when the guy attacks me. Okay? So we can't allow our kids get away. I'm gonna put that guy. I'm not creating the same power as I would if I like this. So, if I'm like this, see how it didn't change? I can't do that. See this? I can't. No. See it? See my position change? It's like this. If my face throws and I look through the position, I'm gonna go in that direction. If my face is here, looking here, looking here, I'm gonna go. So I always want to create that face pressure. That's how you help always when that guy's face against that guy's body. A couple more minutes, we'll move on. But it's hard to get after you get a certain age, though, because it's just not the, you know, we're used to level change and penetrating. We're not used to it. They start off like this, doing that. That action technique. The last 20 years, you're trying to get that action. It's a good action. It's effective because guys aren't trained necessarily to. When I wrestled a guy from Germany in the World Championships 1 year, I knew he was also in high cross. Also in high cross in my right leg. So I could never take this arm away from his leg until I had it. Once I had it, I could tie it up. But from an open stance, I can never get caught reaching. I can never get caught doing this. So my breath is coming. So, same principle, different technique. Boom! I bang it. Now, it's up to you or up to your kids or up to the officials determine how hard you can bang. Now, for me, I bang hard. And when I used to wrestle at the senior level, just to set the tone, just to let the guy know it was going to be a fight, it was going to be a war, we come out, bam, I bang hard. The referee might look at you and I bang, woo! The referee says, hey! You know, he might be speaking some foreign language or something. I tell you to shake hands, you know, with that. Walk, shake hands, whistle blow, bam! But that was just a set the tone. So they, you know, they never give it. I've never seen them give away a point. Now, I've never seen them give away. Oh, I think we might have. We got buyers got screwed last.
They do this, but they don't give a point.
The deal is, if I'm coming with this, boom, this is different than this. Now, I can guys with this. Bam! You know, but I'm coming. Same deal, forearm, power. So this is the deal. You can do it without grabbing his arm because you're anticipating his arm coming up. So it's like this. See it? His arms. Naturally, kids aren't come up. Or come up. So it's the same deal. So you can bang, go. Pretty effective. I see it a lot. That's how I, what your kid is looking for. I'm very seldom grab the collar. Very seldom do I ever let a guy grab a collar, unless I'm passive, unless I'm being passive on purpose. If I do let him grab a collar, I thumb block a position, and I keep him at distance. Look how much distance he has to cover. That's if I'm being passive. I'm trying to hold him to a lead without looking passive. I don't want to be this passive, this guy passive. My passive would be, see it? He's got to beat this arm before he gets to me now. 1 point lead, 10 seconds left, whatever. You know what I mean? He's got, that's right, he'd have to come out of that position in order to wrestle. So I would never let a guy hang collar per se. But if a guy does grab collar, you can grab his elbow, especially if he heads on this side. Guys feel comfortable here. Here's an axe. Good elbow, run, tap down. Most of the time, my head's on this side. See this? Head's on this side. Or, since I don't let him hang collar, the best guy to know, he grabs it up. Most of them will grab it. This is a good axe. See what he did right here? This is a baseline skill. We don't teach it at the kids' level. This is a skill that has to be developed by our kid. Because look, inside control is okay. If it's like this. If he does this, he better be ready to wrestle because I got him now. He don't have inside control anymore. You know what I mean? He's in trouble. See this? He can always go from thumb outside, or thumb inside to thumb outside to change, but if he's inside, he better be grabbing me like this. Because if he's not, I got him. He's not controlled anymore.
Ken, when teaching that, when they're drilling, they'll hold each other off.
Here's the deal.
How do we explain to the kids?
So here's the deal. If we're both going to, you know what I'm saying? I don't have to let him have it. I don't have to. See, I'll come up. So I can. Now, when you're teaching your kid, it's a spar. It's a drill. So in a drill, of course, understand, when it's a drill, it's a different mentality. So when we're drilling, I'll give him. But when you're drilling, you give him this too. So even if he does do this, you gotta get to deal with it. You gotta get to deal with it, you know? See? So when I tie that, this is a skill. Now, if you're like Tom Brands, and you got that kind of physicality, this is their tie. But they're constantly, they're constantly grinding me out. See this? Now this can't be a pack. If you got a kid that can put this kind of pressure on him, you can get away with that kind of tie up. But then there are a few guys out there that can do that. We end up like this, getting the tap. Okay? So, here's a duck I'll show you. It's kind of tricky, kind of slick. He grabs his side control. I have the elbow. For me, my head would pop outside. A lot of times I would do this. Do my head pop outside. That's my double leg side. If your single leg side is better for you. But here it is. Because he's inside, he thinks he's fit. A lot of times it's like this. Good guys, I give him an inside, he gives me an inside. I take an outside, he takes an outside. Right? When you wrestle with a good guy, that's really how it works, right? We end up tying up and staying even. So here I am. All I'm doing is this. Penetrate! From here I pull. It's real slick in that situation, the guy falls over. Because he defends so hard. And this is the key. My knee sits here, not here. My knee sits here. Keep looking. This way, get around. All right? Why are you driving? See it? If he is not blocking me, Coach. If he is not blocking me, see it? He is not blocking me. Okay? No more thumb block, right? So your kids can work on that as well. Alright? So this is where it comes. This is really the action. And a lot of times you'll feel me coming and he'll go lay back. Here comes single. I'll float run through that position. So I know I can roll through stuff kind of quick because I know you guys can see it again, but fearlessly, you're trying to get a few things that your guys can use in this coming season. I know that. But you're able to take away a few things that guys can actually use. I mean, time well spent, but I'm sure you did a lot more out of it. He's actually sending a video. Before I show the last thing I'm going to go over is this action. See this? This right here is a subtle movement, but I'm in full control of the tire. I can score on him, he can score on me. Okay? So, along with your own setups and your own attacks, in full control of the tie-up. You also have to have a philosophy against better guys that where are they going to allow you to wrestle them from? Where's a good guy going to allow me to wrestle him from? So when you start getting better kids wrestling better guys, you start thinking, okay, now this kid's going to give this tie and he'll allow you to wrestle from there. So you try to develop attacks from the tie-up set that guy will give you. Perfect example is this, inside. Here's a great attack. From this elbow right here, he'll rush from here because he feels safe. He feels safe. See this? But he's really not safe. See, that's good. He needs to get that down and block. But a lot of times I can be here. And a lot of times he can't get away from this. Even if he has my elbow here, it's okay. Head position. All I'm going to do is this. See it? See the pull? See the that's a hard stop. Big pull. That's hard to stop. Side. Guys feel safe. Also from the same action, you know, because he feels safe. Because he feels safe. So the more positions you can attack, where that guy runs you from, feels safe from, the better your kid's gonna be. This last thing I'm gonna show is probably the most important, but it's a baseline of skill. We have a baseline skills where head and hands are first line of defense, and really our head doesn't come into the picture too much, and it should, because anytime my head becomes my first line, I'm automatically in a reshot situation. Anytime I drop head and hands off of offensive action, or a fake, I'm in a reshot situation. Like this. That kind of action. Or say I'm here. Relax. Anytime I drop hand-to-hands, I defend myself, and I'm in a reshot situation, reshot action. he always had great skills. He attacked more, he had a skill mentality, hard wrestling, but bring your skills to the table mentality. But with a 1-point lead against the best guys, it doesn't even matter if it's little time left. But this is baseline. The ability to defend yourself at all times. The ability to go get attacked when you need to score is a baseline philosophy. So, with that in mind, I always have to have the mentality that I'm always ready to protect myself. That means dropping heavy hands. So here's the deal. We're just going to be sparring here, and he's just going to play. See my head? I never let his head beat my head. So he's going to go, and it's going to be more of a sparring type action. I can use my hands, or I can drop my hands, depending on how much I feel threatened. But here's the action, bro. See off that counter position, how I created an angle, how I had a reshot? Look at it. So, see it? So I use my hands. Sometimes, in the big heart. Yeah. I'm happy. But see how I'm keeping my head in between his attack? This is bottom line, baseline skill here. So, all you're working on is he's gonna break, he's gonna try to shoot, you're gonna go. You're gonna try to keep your head, go ahead. Your head stays, you're beating with your head. See, you my hand, my hand can beat. My head drops, he can't get to my leg. Okay? That is a baseline skill from a position standpoint. Don't let him beat your head. Head and hands. Alright? Three sets for these. Spar this out, you said. Go ahead. This is what becomes natural. It becomes natural. It becomes a natural instinct. Just like down blocking and sprawling, a natural instinct. I mean, we're trying to teach our athletes to be instinctive where they develop habits. They develop habits where they react instinctively, either having to think about them, stop about them, doing what they feel instead of what they know. You're trying to train them in that fashion. Here's another drill. That shuffle drill is a drill, down by drill is a drill, but here's one. I'm gonna do this. He didn't beat my head. He didn't beat me that time, did he, right? And he might have to really drop. That's what he might have to draw. What's the problem? He might have to stop. What's the problem? That's what happened right there. He'll fall in on the leg sometime, and this guy won't know how he got there. Sometimes he just will have to work through that finish. So that's a drill. It's the same thing here. Anyway.